Romans chapter 15, verse 29.
If you brought your Bibles, lift it up. Let me see. Say, this is my Bible. It is the word of God. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. And I can do what it says I can do. In Jesus' name, say a big amen.
Romans 15, 29. Can we stand for the reading of God's word? Thank you, Holy Father. Romans 15, 29. And I want us to read with force, with passion. One, two, three, go. And I am sure that when I come unto you, I shall come in the fullness of the blessing of the gospel of Christ. Amen. Let's be seated. So Apostle Paul speaking here, he said that, but I know that when I come unto you, I am sure that when I come unto you, I shall come in the fullness of the blessing of the gospel of Christ. And my message for this morning is living in the fullness of the blessing. Living in the fullness of the blessing. Living in the fullness of the blessing. Apostle Paul speaking said, when I come unto you, I shall come in the fullness of the blessing of the gospel of Christ. Now, the word fullness means complete or having reached the highest or the greatest level or degree. Fullness means complete or having reached the greatest level or the highest degree. It also means the blessing without measure. Somebody say the blessing without measure. It also means going beyond any previous limits. Even though most of us have never experienced that, God is saying it is available. He said, I am sure that when I come unto you, I will come in the fullness of the blessing. Somebody say the fullness of the blessing. Even though there may be people in this place this very morning that have not yet reached this dimension or level, I want you to understand this morning that it is still available. Touch your neighbor, say it is available. I said, tell your neighbor it is available. There is always a possibility that you could be the one that can break the limit in your family. How many of you believe that? There is a possibility that you could be the one that can break the limit in your family. And this season, somebody is about to break that limit. I thought I will hear an amen. Wave your hands and say a big amen. I've been living in the blessing of the Lord for almost 20 years. And of course, it's progressive. You move from one level onto another level. I've been living in the blessing, and it looks as if where I am today, I have matured and grown more than where I used to be yesterday, because the blessing of God is in levels. And this very morning, I see that somebody is about to move from one level to another level. Somebody said another level. Come on, say it was, say another level. No matter what level you have reached in life, there is always another level. True or false? There is always another level. No matter how prosperous you are right now, there is always another level. No matter how favored you are right now, there is always another level. We have to place a very high value on the blessing and choose the blessing. Because the Bible says it is the blessing of the Lord that maketh a man rich and added no sorrow with it. And I see somebody walking in the highest degree and in the highest dimension of the blessing. If you are the one, wave your hands and shout a hallelujah. I said shout a hallelujah. Hold the hand of a neighbor, say you can break the limit.
Oh, come on, say it with passion. You can break the limit.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1 to 2. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandment, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Blessed shall thou be in the city, and blessed shall thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, and the increase of thy kine, and the flocks of thy sheep. Say a big amen. Many times when we talk about the word blessing, or when the word blessing is mentioned, people think majorly about financial or material welfare. When we hear the word blessing, many times what comes to mind is financial or material welfare. But I want you to understand that the blessing goes beyond financial or material welfare. It includes it, but it goes beyond it. The word bless in Hebrew is barak. Somebody say barak. I'm not talking about Barack Obama. Somebody say barak. And barak is from the root word barake. B-A-R-A-K-E-H. Barake. Which means to succeed. So the word blessing means to succeed. Empowered to succeed. Empowered to prosper. Empowered to excel. Empowered to rise above. So anytime you hear somebody say unto another person, the Lord bless you, what it simply means is that may the Lord empower you to succeed. Am I communicating? It means that may the Lord empower you to excel. So I'm going to say the Lord bless you three times over your life. And as you are responding with a big amen, what you are saying is that Lord empower me to succeed. Are you ready? May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. So the blessing goes beyond financial or material welfare, even though it includes it. It means empowered to rise above, empowered to prosper, empowered to succeed, empowered to excel. And this very morning, I see somebody rising above every limitation in the name of Jesus Christ. Can I teach? Wonderful. There are two things the blessing contains. There are two things the blessing contains. Number one, the blessing is a sorrow-free dimension of existence. When we say a man is blessed, when we say a woman is blessed, it means that that man or woman is living in a sorrow-free dimension of existence. The Bible said in Proverbs chapter 10 verse 22, the blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich, and he added no sorrow with it. So when we say you are blessed, it means that sorrow is far from you. It means that affliction is far from you. When we say you are blessed, it means that calamity is far from you. It means that catastrophe is far from you. When we say a man or a woman is blessed, it means that you are living in a sorrow-free realm. That is number one. Number two, the blessing is existence with divine favor and goodwill of God. Existence with divine favor or goodwill of God. When we say you are blessed, what we are trying to say is that the favor of God and the goodwill of God is on your life, or is backing whatever you are doing. When God favors you, or when his goodwill is behind you, that means you are walking in the blessing. No human bad will can stop you, because you are walking in the blessing of the Lord. Somebody said the blessing of the Lord. So the blessing of the Lord, number one, you're living in a sorrow-free realm. And number two, the favor of God is upon your life. Aren't you happy to hear that? Put your hands together for Jesus. Come on, clap all for Jesus. There are three avenues by which the blessing is guaranteed. There are three avenues by which the blessing is guaranteed. Number one, the avenue of creation. The avenue of creation.
In Genesis chapter 1, verse 26 through 28. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, over the cattle, and over the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them, and God blessed them. Look at that. Immediately God created man. God pronounced his blessing upon them. God blessed them, and the Lord said, be fruitful. In other words, I have empowered you to succeed. I've empowered you to excel. He said, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth, subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth. So the first avenue of the blessing is the avenue of creation. Somebody said the avenue of creation. Now look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I was created to live blessed. Oh, I don't like the way you are saying it. Shake another neighbor's hand. Say, neighbor, I want you to shout it. Neighbor, I was created to live blessed. I was created to live blessed. The second avenue of the blessing is the avenue of the Abrahamic covenant. The avenue of the Abrahamic covenant. Genesis chapter 12, verse 2 and 3. God speaking to Abraham said, and I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee, and in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. So through Abraham, or through the Abrahamic covenant, everyone who is a member of the human family is guaranteed the blessing. Am I teaching? Through the Abrahamic covenant, and how many of you know that in Galatians chapter 3 verse 29, the Bible says, if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. Galatians chapter 3 verse 29. Galatians 3, 29. And if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. So if you are connected to Abraham, if you are part of the human family connected to Abraham, then you are guaranteed the blessing. So the first avenue is the avenue of creation. The second avenue is the avenue of the Abrahamic covenant. And the third avenue is the avenue of redemption. 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 Jesus died on the cross of Calvary to receive the blessing that Adam lost for us. And I love what scripture said in Revelation chapter 5 verse 12. Revelation 5:12, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. Somebody say blessing. I'm using King James. Give me King James. King James. And blessing. Hold the hand of a neighbor. Look into the neighbor's face, eyeball to eyeball. Say, neighbor, if God created you at all, come on, shout it, shout it, shout it. Say, hey, sister, if God created you at all, you have the heritage of the blessing. If you are Abraham's seed, you have the heritage of the blessing. And if you have anything to do with Jesus Christ, you have the heritage of the blessing. How many of you have the heritage of the blessing? Jump up on your feet and give the Lord a shout. Shout. If you have the heritage of the blessing, give a neighbor a high five. Say, I am blessed. Come on, say it like you believe it. I am blessed. Come on, shout it like you believe it. I am blessed. I am blessed. Be seated. In heavenly places, you are blessed. The question now is, why are many people not walking in the reality of the blessing, even though you are blessed? Why are many of us not manifesting the blessing of God? Because the blessing of God maketh a man rich, add no sorrow to it. So if you say you are blessed, why are you not walking in the reality of the blessing? Now the reason is very simple. Every provision of God has conditions for man. Every provision of God has conditions for man. God is a covenant keeper. He gives the provision and he gives the conditions. Now you have to keep the condition that God will release the provision. How many of you understand that in a big family, a man will always release his inheritance or his properties onto the very responsible son or daughter of his? But if you are irresponsible, if you are useless, you aren't going to get nothing. Am I communicating? Now, in a family, the man will always, even if the responsible child is the last child, the man or the woman will pass on all his or her inheritance onto the last child instead of releasing onto the first child who is irresponsible. Likewise, in the body of Christ, there are many Christians who are irresponsible. That is why we are not walking in the reality of the blessing of God. God is a God of principles. God, listen to me, principles are superior to principalities. In life, you walk by principles. You don't walk by the fear of principalities or demons or powers of darkness, even though they exist. Your mother could be a witch, but if you are living by principle, that the Bible said, honor your mother and father so that it will be well with you and your days will be long, your mother cannot use that familiar spirit against your life. It will never work because you are living by principle. Am I communicating? I'm helping somebody. I'm not hyping you this morning. I'm helping you. God is a God of principle. God is a God of order. God is a God who believes in covenant and who believes in conditions. So many of us are not manifesting or are not walking in the fullness of the blessing simply because we have become irresponsible Christians. But I pray for you that the grace to change levels, to move to the next level, that you will pay the price for the blessing. It will come on your life in the name of Jesus. Wave your hands and shout hallelujah. I said wave your hands and shout hallelujah. All truth is parallel. As it is in the physical, so it is in the spiritual. All truth is parallel. And God will never bless the irresponsible. Look at your neighbor's face. Say, sister. Oh, please say it with passion. Say, brother. God will never bless the irresponsible. He will never bless the irresponsible. He will never forget it. He will never. He will never. Bless the irresponsible. Many of us are blessed by title, but we are not manifesting the blessing of God. If you are blessed, money should be part of you. If you are blessed, you should be walking in a realm of material blessing. If you are blessed, it must be well with you spiritually, physically, financially, mentally, emotionally. You can't tell me you are blessed and you are poor. You can't tell me you are blessed and you are broke. You can't tell me you are blessed and you have nothing to write home about. Because the blessing of God maketh rich. It maketh rich. But I pray for somebody this morning that the grace to walk in the principle, the grace to walk in the condition, it will come on your life in the name of Jesus. Wave your hands and shout hallelujah. I have six of them. I'm going to share three with us. I will share three during the second service. Number one, the first channel of the blessing is righteousness. Somebody say righteousness. 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 In Psalm 5 verse 12, for thou, Lord, will bless the righteous.
With favor will thou compass him as with a shield. The Lord will bless the righteous. Psalm 5 verse 12. How many righteous people do we have here this morning? May the Lord bless you. Oh, I didn't hear your amen. May the Lord bless you. I didn't hear your amen. May the Lord bless you. For thou, Lord, will bless the righteous. With favor will thou compass him as with a shield. I like what Moses said in Exodus chapter 32 verse 29. Exodus 32, 29. For Moses has said, consecrate yourselves. In other words, purify yourself. Sanctify yourself. Today to the Lord, even every man upon his son and upon his brother. Why? That he may bestow upon you a blessing this day. Let's all read the scripture on the screen. 1, 2, 3, go. For Moses has said, consecrate yourselves. Even every man upon his son and upon his brother, that he may bestow upon you a blessing this day. Somebody say, a blessing this day. Now hold the hand of a neighbor. Say, neighbor, crookedness is a major foundation for wretchedness. There are many of us that are not living to please God. There are many of us that don't fear God at all. There are many of us, our pathways are not good. But I pray for somebody. There are many of us, our conscience is not awake. Our conscience is dead. When we sin, we don't even regret that we have sinned. And when we are even living in sin, we don't regret, or we don't even, we have a dead conscience. Am I communicating? Why should a Christian continue to fornicate? Why should a married man or a married woman continue to walk in adultery? I mean, you are an accountant and you are in an office and you are always adding more zeros to the figures. You are adding more crookedness. It is the foundation for wretchedness. God can never bless the unrighteous. God only blesses the righteous. Church members don't want us to preach holiness again. Church members don't want us to preach sanctification again. But ladies and gentlemen, without holiness, it is impossible to please God and to see God. I pray for you that God will put on you the garment of holiness. God will only bless the righteous. He will only bless the righteous. He will only bless the righteous. Show me a righteous man, and I will show you a man who is walking in the reality, or who is walking in the fullness of the blessing. Somebody say, the fullness of the blessing. Come on, say the fullness of the blessing. Many of us are living in bitterness. Many of us are living in unforgiveness. Many of us are living in hatred. Many of us are living in jealousy. Many of us are living in anger. I pray for you this morning that any sin you find yourself in, the power of the Holy Ghost will bring you out in the name of Jesus Christ. Wave your hands and shout, thank you, Jesus. I said, shout, thank you, Jesus. The Lord will bless the righteous. Live by principles, not by opinions. Uprightness and righteousness pays any day. Uprightness and righteousness, it pays any day. Tell the neighbor, it pays any day. Tell another neighbor, it pays any day. Number two, obedience. 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 We are talking about the channels of the blessing. Number two, obedience. You must refuse to live as a rebel and obey divine instructions. In Genesis 12, 1 and 2, now the Lord has said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show you. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless you and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And the Bible said Abraham obeyed, and the Lord blessed Abraham. Obedience is key to the blessing. Tell your neighbor, obedience is key to the blessing. Come on, say it. Say obedience is key to the blessing. Now, what the Lord told Abraham was that, Abraham, there is a place that I have prepared for you, and that place is called appointed place. And I want you to move from this place onto your appointed place, and as you go there, I will bless you. I will make thy name great so that you shall be a blessing. There are many of us that God has been speaking to us to move from where we are to our next level, and we are still at where we are. That is why we are struggling and suffering. But if you will obey the word of God to move, God will bless you. Am I communicating? Touch your neighbor, say obey, obey. Touch your neighbor, say obey. Come on, say it was, say obey. Come on, shout it, say obey. In Deuteronomy chapter 11, 26 and 27, behold, I set before you this day a blessing and a curse. A blessing, if ye obey the commandment of the Lord your God, which I command you this day. Obedience brings blessings. Disobedience brings curses. Obeying God, obeying spiritual authority, obeying your father, obeying your earthly parents, obeying or obedience brings blessings. Touch your neighbor, say, please obey God. Come on, say it once, say, please obey God. You have 100% to obey God. Obedience is doing the will of God. How many of you are ready to do the will of God? Obedience is doing the will of God. Yesterday I was speaking to somebody and she said, my desire is to do his will. I said, I have nothing more to add to it. My desire is to do the will of God. Obedience is going the way of God. Somebody say, going the way of God. Go in the way of God. Obedience. Obedience is taking God and his word seriously. You take God, you take his word seriously. Obedience is avoiding the way of rebellion and stubbornness. And lastly, obedience is the refusal of taking God and his word for granted. Obedience is the refusal of taking God and his word for granted. Say a big amen. Come on, say it was, say a big amen. The last condition I'll give to us this morning is tithing and giving. Tithing and giving. Tithing and giving. This is the anchor on which all the other points rest. You can fast for 100 days. You can live a holy life. You can be the most holiest lady in this church. If you are not a tither, you will never see money. Somebody say money. How do you say it in Kenya? Eh? How do you say, eh? Pesa. Touch your neighbor. Say, neighbor, if you are not a tither, you will never see pesa. You can fast for 200 days, 100 days, 100 years until you become a tither. You can win 20 souls every week. If you don't know how to release financially to God, you will never be able to receive financially from God. Many times God uses our giving to prove our heart. Oh, I'm teaching this morning. God uses our giving to prove our heart. If you want, touch your neighbor, hold the hand of a neighbor, say, neighbor, if you want to know where a man's heart is, find out where he spends his money. Touch your neighbor, say, he's teaching cry. Touch your neighbor, say, he's teaching cry. Come on, grab the hand of anybody. Say, neighbor. When we say a woman has taken a man's heart, it means that the man has made the woman the focus of his expenditure. Hey! Now when I shout A, you also respond A. A! Oh, I'm not feeling you. A! A!
Matthew chapter 6 verse 21. Put on the screen as we close. Matthew chapter 6 verse 21. Thank you, Holy Father. Matthew 6 21. Matthew chapter 6 verse 21. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. In our church in Ghana, before I can appoint you, or I will appoint you in leadership position, you must first be a tither. Not for the church to have money, but to know where your heart is. Because if your heart is for the kingdom, your money will be for the kingdom. But if your heart is for something else, your treasure will be for something else. Am I preaching this morning? I pray for you this morning, and you will be a tither. Many of the ladies, they use their tithe to buy Brazilian hair. So you see them sharply dressed, going to House of Grace every Sunday morning, shaking their head like this. My tithe, my tithe, my tithe. If you are sitting beside a lady, ask that lady, I hope you are not a suspect. I hope you are not a victim. Most of the young men also use their tithe to buy shirt, to buy suit, to buy shoes. Some of them even use their tithe to buy cars. The latest mobile phone, then you use your tithe to go and buy. Everybody lift your mobile phone. Let me see. Let me make sure it's not your tithe. The reason why many of us financially are tight, T-I-G-H-T, is because we don't tithe. So you are always tight. So everything is tight in your life. Your money is tight. Your walking is even tight. But when you're a faithful tither, everything is loose. Everything is blessed. Am I communicating? That many of us also are faithful. No, let me say it this way. That many of us who are consistent, but we are not faithful. Every day pastor calls tithe, you are standing at the altar. Give me an envelope. Give me all the envelopes. Everybody watch me. So every Monday, pastor calls tight, you are here. The next day, pastor calls tight, you come. And when you are bringing your tight, you don't even walk, you are dancing. And you are smiling because the Lord loves a cheerful giver. Another time, they call for tight and you are dancing, you are coming. You are very consistent, but you are not faithful. Because a tithe of $100 is $10. But many of you pay $9, $8, $5, $6. And watch this. Anytime you drop your tithe at the altar and it is not the right amount, God converts it to offering. So you receive offering blessing, not tithe blessing. Clap for Jesus. The only key that will cause the heavens to be open, that God will bless you, that you will not have room to accommodate, is when you are faithful with your tithe. There are many of us that God is speaking to us this morning, that this error of tithe must be corrected in our lives. Look into a neighbor's face. Ask the neighbor, are you a tither?
Oh, Saint Wah, are you sure you're a tighter?
Ask another neighbor. I hope you are not a suspect. I hope you are not a victim. I hope you are not a suspect. Anywhere a person's heart is, that is where his money is. If your heart is for God, your money will be for God. And I end my message by telling all of us that the key to walk in the fullness of the blessing is not only through prayer and fasting, but you becoming faithful with your tithe and offering, with your giving. It's a major key. Why are the Muslims always blessed? Like I said earlier on, every truth is parallel. All truth is parallel. You can see one Muslim building a mosque for a whole community. God continues to bless that Muslim because when it comes to the law of giving, it is general. It is for all categories, the Jews and the Gentiles. Am I communicating? You may not be holy, but if you are a tither, you will still be blessed. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't stay holy. Please. Am I communicating? When it comes to money, somebody say money. How many of you love money? How many of you like money? You love money. Somebody say money. Touch your neighbor. Say money. They say neighbor. If you want to see money, tell your neighbor, if you want to see dollars, tell them, touch your neighbor. Say, if you want to see dollars, grab the hand of a neighbor. Say, neighbor, if you want to see foreign currency, every day in your pockets, every day in your account, you must be a tither. You must be a giver. You must be a tither. You must be a giver. You must be a tither. You must be a giver. In the name of Jesus. Let me end here. Put your hands together and rise to your feet.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Lift your hands wherever you are. Come on. How great thou art.